Hey, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video on BMW B48 engine problems. The BMW B48 engine has been in production since 2014 and remains in production to this day. It is the replacement for the BMW N20 engine, which is also a 2-liter turbocharged inline 4 engine. And the B48, although it's been in production since 2014, it really didn't start fully phasing out the N20 until 2017. So those couple years before, the B48 wasn't a couple cars here and there, mostly outside of the US market. So here in the United States, the B48's predominantly been in use from 2017 up until the present day. So again, it's a 2-liter inline 4 turbocharged engine. And like many BMW modern turbocharged BMW engines, it also uses direct injection, valvetronic, as well as double vanos. Ultimately, the B48 makes anywhere from 154 to 302 horsepower and 184 to 332 pound-feet of torque. Those upper numbers of 300 horsepower and 332 pound-feet of torque, that is for a slightly different variant of the B48. So we're not gonna get into that too much in this video since we're mostly just here for common problems. But most B48s fall in roughly the 240 to 255 horsepower ballpark and similar torque figures. So just wanted to point out that higher tier power is for a special B48. So a little bit unique and not something that's here in the US market as of now. Jumping right into BMW B48 common engine problems. Number one, we have valve cover gasket oil leaks, and this is something that's been a common problem on pretty much every BMW engine for the past couple decades, and it's also a common problem on many other engines outside of just BMW. Of course, gaskets, O-ring seals, they're prone to degrading and simply drying out and wearing down with age and mileage and heat cycling. And so with that, those gaskets eventually just start drying out and cracking, which leads to an oil leak from the valve cover gasket. And so the reason we wanted to highlight the valve cover gasket here is that's really the most common oil leak on the B48 so far. We'll see if a couple others start popping up as the B48 continues aging and getting older. On other BMW engines, the oil filter housing gasket's another leak that commonly pops up, as well as occasionally the front and rear main seals. A couple different oil leaks to be on the lookout for as the B48 continues aging. Relatively simple and straightforward issue here. It does take a little bit of labor to get in there and replace the valve cover gasket. And depending on the mileage, if you do run into this problem, it might be a good idea just to go ahead and replace that entire valve cover. Just for the added safety, if you're already paying that money in labor, the parts aren't going to be much more expensive. Moving on to another common issue for the BMW B48, and this is something that's just recently been starting to pop up as well. So the B48 has been starting to run into a couple cracks in the oil filter housing. So what happens when that oil filter housing cracks? It tends to be in the 70 to 80,000 mile range. Some have happened a little before, some have happened a little later. So again, we'll see how much more common this becomes once more B48s eclipse that 100,000 mile mark. Number of cases already involving cracked oil filter housings on the B48. And what happens is when that does crack, the coolant tends to leak out very rapidly. Or you may also be left with oil and coolant mixing with each other. Oil and coolant mixing is never a good thing for an engine. When you have coolant mixing in with that engine oil, it's going to affect the lubrication of the engine. And if that's left alone for too long, that can potentially start to cause some additional damage and harm to the engine. Definitely something to be on the lookout for. Make sure you don't have any oil mixing with the coolant. It should be noticeable before you drive around for too long with oil and coolant mixing together. But nonetheless, that oil filter housing is about a $300 part. It does take some time and effort to actually replace the oil filter housing. since you will have to remove the intake manifold, and one of the bolts on the bottom of the oil filter housing is a little bit of a pain. Certainly going to be a bit more expensive if you end up at a repair shop or a BMW dealer for that issue, but if you can DIY, then again, the part's about $300. In the grand scheme, not a super problematic issue here, but certainly something to be on the lookout for and keep in mind as the B48 continues aging. Moving on to problem number three here, this is something that has truly just recently come up. BMW actually issued a technical service bulletin for it, and they consider it a service action rather than a recall. Any affected models will have this part replaced for free, and that issue is with the coolant vent line on the cylinder head. Now, this technical service bulletin has been issued for the F chassis models, and just the 2, 3, and 4 series, so it seems to be only affecting those vehicles at this current time. If you own an F chassis 2, 3, or 4 series, you may have already heard from a local BMW dealer or BMW of North America about coming in to have that part fixed. Or next time you end up at a BMW dealer, they will probably recommend doing that replacement. It'll be totally free. Minor issue in that sense. Basically, what happens according to the technical service bulletin is the quick disconnect coupling on the head simply breaks, at which point coolant starts leaking out from that vent line very rapidly. And BMW ultimately just stated that they found out that this coolant line cannot handle the excessive heat and temperatures over the lifetime of the part, which is why they're now replacing them on all of these affected models. Minor issue in the grand scheme, just something to be on the lookout for if you do own an F chassis, a 2, 3, or 4 series. Go ahead and check that out. Give your local BMW dealership a call. See if there is that open service bulletin for your car and go ahead and get that knocked out sooner than later, just for peace of mind. Fortunately, BMW did come out with that service action, so that should be hopefully a non-issue moving forward. It will, of course, be interesting to see if any similar issues start popping up on different models like the X models or the larger 5 series. For now, hopefully that's just limited to the 2, 3, and 4 series and the F chassis. And again, if you have one of those models, just get that checked out and get that fixed as soon as you possibly can. That really wraps up our B48 common problems video. It really doesn't suffer from a whole lot of issues, and most of them have just started popping up in the last couple of years, which makes sense because as engines do hit that 6, 7, 8-year-old ballpark, and especially as they start climbing to 80,000 plus miles, the occasional problems and failures become a little bit more common. So the B48 is a very reliable engine, reliable enough that Toyota is even using the B48 in the Supra. And so that goes to show that the B48 is a very capable and reliable engine. Issues are just starting to pop up, but because a couple issues are popping up, isn't anything to hold against the B48. Very standard as cars start aging again, gaskets, O-rings, hoses start becoming brittle and just wear down from those heat cycles and constant heating and cooling of those parts, and just age in general also takes a toll on anything rubber, plastic, or composite, anything like that. Nothing against the B48, but it is still a relatively new engine. So time will tell if more of these minor problems start popping up here and there. But for now, it's been a very reliable engine, and internally there haven't been any severe issues or any known issues, so it's very reliable internally, and if there are just a couple oil leaks or coolant leaks that pop up here and there, so be it. That's pretty standard for any car, especially for a higher-end BMW engine. If you guys appreciated the video, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and check out the description below for more content on the B48 engine. Thanks, guys.